creator of the universe, lover of our souls, Emmanuel with us, Holy Spirit, fire of life. We praise you with all the names that we hold dear, names which call us and draw us into your precious space. Thank you for being with us and among us. Thank you for preparing this place for us. Thank you for opening our hearts to know and receive and experience you this day and every day. We thank you for your witness that you have shared with us throughout the generations, through your word, through your prophets, the disciples, through all of those who have come before us and offered us a word of hope, a word of compassion, a word of care. We thank you for your wondrous works, and especially in this season of the year, we are reminded to prepare and be expectant of all the things that you have ready for us, that our hearts would be mended, that our lives would be reunited, that our spirits would be refreshed and set together anew. We thank you for this, your good work, through Jesus Christ, for the humble, wondrous beauty of your gift. May we this afternoon be inspired by that gift through the amazing and wonderful gifts you have provided in this time and space of singers and musicians, of hearers, of those who are present to receive. May these gifts grow and blossom and be so grand they leave this place to burn with the beauty of your love in the world, that the expectation of this season would bubble forth, that the music would inspire us and sing through us of your glory. We lift up to you our hearts this day, carrying all those whom we love, those who are able to be with us, those who have gone on before us, those that are in other places and unable to be present. And I would like to especially lift up those who are on our hearts, who are in need of your love, your healing, your hope. Today especially, I pray for those who have been in the path of destructive storms that caught people off guard and have transformed entire communities. May they know the presence that you bring to offer hope and courage, and may we be a part of that beautiful love shared through the gifts that we can give. May they know they are wrapped in the arms of your love, just as we know and experience that here today. Inspire us in these moments. Transform our hearts and make them new and every day, that we would be your people, walking in your way. Your light would shine through Advent, through Christmas, throughout every part of our year. Grow us in faith. Guide us in wisdom. We pray all these things together in your grace, in your holiness, in the name of Emmanuel. God bless.
Thank you. Thank you. Lord, there may be some here who have not found the joy and salvation that only you can bring. We pray that this will be the moment they whisper, Jesus, be the center of my life today. Come into my heart and be Lord and Savior. There may be others who have forgotten what it was like when they first knew your tender love and mercy, and they responded to it so readily. We pray that this will be the moment that they'll reach out to you and say, Jesus, be the center once more of everything I am. Let us never come to Christmas without being intimately aware that you are the reason, the heart, the center of it all. We love you, we worship you, and we give ourselves to you anew, saying, Jesus, you are the center of our joy. We pray all this in your beautiful name. Amen. Prophecies about the one that God would send to redeem us, and every one of them was fulfilled
But I have to tell you, this was a little spark in my brain back in 2018. And in 2019, we were engaged with Priscilla Lockett playing the piano. And I was on the organ a little bit at First Church, and I talked to Doris Diggs, who is now a member of Crooks United Methodist, and I said, wouldn't it be fun to join the choirs together, Central and First? Well, as you see, 2020 shut us down. So in July, Nancy Blagg, Kay Marshall, Jerry Sowers, and I met at Wesley, and I said, let's do this thing. So I want to tell you that it has been a joy to be with this group of worship leaders. They're not just singers. See, we're proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so when we leave here today, we're not Phoebus, we're not Wesley, we're not Central, and we're not First Church. You see, we're all believers, the family of God in one fellowship, serving the same God, spreading the same message, the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I hope that you will take the joy that you've experienced today and share it with others you encounter. And it's not easy. You know, it's easy to witness right here in these walls. But I encourage you, as I encourage and challenge myself, to be a witness of the hands and feet of Christ in your community. And thank you so much, Central, Robert and Charles and Francis, for your hospitality. You've been very gracious to us. And for Central hosting this event, Charles, thank you for allowing